Greetings to you all. All over the world, you are blessed and you are highly favored. And to God Almighty be the glory. This is Eddie Francis, Pastor Ajimadia Francis, the missionary. I've come on your way to share with you this motivation message, and I believe that it's going to be a blessing to your soul. God bless you, and may God bless this motivation message. According to the book of Psalm 125, that is where we are coming to take our motivation message from. And we are going to talk about trust. Are you going to trust about God, the creator, or the creatures? Whom have you put your trust? Psalm 125 says, those who trust in the Lord are like Mount Zion. Those who trust in the Lord are like Mount Zion, which cannot be moved, but abides forever. As the mountains around Jerusalem, so the Lord surround his people from this time forth and forever. And I say, where have you put your trust? Where have you put your trust? Those that trust in the Lord, those that trust in the Lord. And dear soul, and I don't want to. And then Yanko Ponson and Cassa, what do I want to be so? What's the one? And they want to and what is so? Those that trust in the Lord, where have you put your trust? Whom have you put your trust? So many things was there, but the word of God didn't say those that trust in such things, but he said, but those that trust in the Lord shall be like a mountain Zion. One that they want to and so woman pay us a Zion people and he made them what down. One that they want to and so and made the same and dear so and I didn't want to. In such a time like this, where have you put your trust? Whom have you put your trust? The word of God didn't say they don't trust in themselves. The word of God didn't say they don't trust in their father. The word of God didn't say they don't trust in their mother. The word of God didn't say they don't trust in their uncle. The word of God didn't say they don't trust in their husband. The word of God didn't say they don't trust in their wife. The word of God didn't say they don't trust in their sisters or their brothers. The word of God didn't say they don't trust in your friends. The word of God didn't say they don't trust in your family. The word of God didn't say they don't trust in your businesses. The word of God didn't say they don't trust in their money. The word of God didn't say they don't trust in your properties. He said those that trust in the Lord. He didn't say none of them. He said they that trust in the Lord. The Bible says they shall be like Mount Zion, which cannot be moved. On various Zion people in him and Timothy. And this shows that when we put our trust in such things like this, it can fail us one day. But when we put our hope and our trust in God, our God never fails. We are serving a God who never fails. There is a song which says, I have a God who never fails. When you put your trust in your money can go one day. When you put your trust in yourself, something can even happen to you one day. When you put your trust in your husband, it can go one day. When you put your trust in your wife, she can go one day. When you put your trust in your uncle, the uncle can neglect you one day. When you put your trust in your brother or your sister, they can fail you one day. When you put your trust in your businesses, your finances, your companies, this all of these things can fail you, but the Bible says we have a God who never fails. But those that trust in God, they are like a mountain Zion that can never be removed, but abides forever. They abide. Nothing can shake you. Nothing can shake you. Because the Bible says, if God be for you, who can be against you? If God, that is how the Bible says, they that trust in the Lord. So if you trust in God, he himself will be your guide, and nothing can shake you. No power, no witches, no demon, no witches. Nothing can shake you because your trust has been found in God. I pray for somebody that may God cause you to put all your trust in him. And to me, my father, hey, not selling a coupon or uncle told, and a Bible say one tonko, now one na, so they would have said him up, and we are taking a coupon, and by your bumper for, or they would have said him up, and we are taking a coupon, and by your yard suffer, or they would have said him up, and we are taking a coupon, and by your coma for, or they would have said him up, and we are taking a coupon, and by what they are, they that trust in the Lord, they that trust, your castle be trusting me, what then, when you know, what then, Regina, he has made that ten his first ten. Oh my God, I pray for you, sir. and fair running codiatry that we are taking a couple, anyone of kind, and what they be away. And that day, so remember, we are there. I your trust. If you can make God your trust, He can fight for you. If you can make God your trust, He can do it for you. If you can make God your trust, He can do everything that you desire. So where have you put your trust? Whom have you put your trust? Young Cassa and Fobi and trust will be never made a couple, and you're the first to trust than any other person you have. If you say a Brahmin of Cassa, obey your radius and chain, and what in a fetch, obey your radius and chain, and what in a tumet, obey your radius and chain, and what in a secretary, obey your radius and chain, and what in a young century, obey your radius and chain. And what in him, Amir, obey your radio sometime, and what in the papa, obey your radio sometime, and what in the company, obey your radio sometime, and what in what could you never saw? That's my cancer, I was a radio 7 years, was the one that you hold to a radio so, and found two women never so, never to my failure one day, but we serve a God who can never fail you. Trust in God. Don't make God second to anything that you do. Let God become your first, and make God your first priority. Don't trade God for silver or gold. And it is the word of God and God who can help you from now and even forever. That is what His word says. As the mountain salons, Jerusalem is for that God, Salons people, even from now and forever. So the Bible was not only talking about now, but forever. What will your end be if you don't have God? Say, and I will hear prayer. Say, we are taking a cup on you when it does what? Say that we are in a prayer. If God is not your trust, how and where will your end be? And how will your end be? Massa, and yes, I say, and we are in a cup. And not in a big castle, sir. But we are taking a cup on you when it does what? If you say, and not only Muslim, but the Watina Muslim here, on him, you will know the things of today, but tomorrow, you don't know what tomorrow will bring forth. So trust in God. And somebody will ask me, Papa, how do I trust in God? Or how can I trust in God? So, as you wish to trust in God, let me give you some components that can accompany you, that can help you to know how to trust in God. Number one, they that trust in God pray in all their doings. They pray about all that they do. They pray, they communicate with God. They don't do it only with their mind shut, but they pray, they depend on God through prayer. So they pray to show God that their strength is not enough for them to win all their battles in life. So they consult God. They consult God. They don't put God second. They put God first. They pray ahead of whatever things that they do. They communicate with God. So if you know how to pray to God, it means you will trust in God. So communicate with God in all your ways to show God that you trust Him. Number two, they get closer to the word of God. This is a sign of those who trust in God. They always get closer to the word of God. They don't go without the word of God. And they believe the word of God is the only source of their strength and their power. And without the word of God, they can do nothing. So those who trust in God, they get closer to the word of God. They get closer to the word of God. The word of God. So to me, you will, and the truth is you trust in God. Gives the right directions. The word of God gives right directions to life. The word of God gives unfailing directions to humanity. Trust in God by getting closer to His word. That is why the word of God came to Joshua in the book of Joshua, chapter 1, verse number 8, and said, "And this book of the Lord shall not depart from your mouth, but you shall meditate in it day and night. But you shall meditate in it day and night." And number three, they act according to His word. They act on the word of God. They act on the word of God. They not trust in God. They act on the word of God. In the book of Joshua chapter 1 verse 8, when you continue reading it, and he says, "That you may observe to do according to all that is written in it." That you may observe to do. That you may be observed to do according to all that is written in it. For then you will make your ways prosperous. And then you will have good success. So they that trust in the Lord, they act according to the word of God. They act on the word of God. Whatever the word of God says, they act on the upon the word. How many radia some yet you say radia some castle on corner or corner, sir? And to say radia some say, hold on, young cousin, you know what's on your cousin, say radia some say, give and it's a be giving back to you. Put mess up, press down, shake it together, running over. That will be poured to your bosom or corner, say your radia smacker. And what you have said, and now Papa Yahua, or call the Sadia Rariasmaka. Free someone, and what you have said, say, I'm Melahua, if it's just Wapa. If the word of God says we should be steadfast, he saw that he would do. First Corinthians chapter 15, verse number 57. That be steadfast, be immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. For you know that your labor in God shall never be in vain. They that trust in God, when they are acting upon the word of God, they have no fear in them because they believe the word of God can do it. They believe the word of God is unfailing. They believe the word of God can never change, can never change, can never change. What the Bible says, whatever. Oh God, the word is certain in heaven forever, forever, forever. Oh God, the word is certain in heaven, and what the Lord has said shall come to pass. What the word of God has said shall surely be as he said it shall be. If the word of God says you shall be the head, so shall it be. If the word of God says you shall be blessed, so shall it be. Depend on the word of God, for they that trust in God shall be like Mount Zion that can never be removed but abides forever. And as the mountains surround Jerusalem, it's so that God surround his people. Say the people of Jerusalem was shalom. And your son here, and we are taking a coupon, and we are taking a coupon. One of us will tell them how much you know. What apostle he says for some trust in chariots, some trust in horses, but we shall remember the name of the Lord. Our hope is in God. He can never fail us. Our faith is in God. He has been with us from the beginning until now. He has been our God, and his word has been with us. We are succeeded by his word. And so shall he continue with us. Trust in this God, and he shall never fail you. Found to sign a coupon. So when you hear what that they that trust in him, they shall be like a mountain Zion. See that mountains can never be shaken. Everything shakes, mountains are always there, and he says, we shall be like a mountain. May God cause you to have understanding upon his word so that you can act according to his word, and his word can become your shield in the battle. Some trust in chariots and some in horses, but we will remember the name of the Lord our God according to Psalm 20, verse 7. So, don't put your trust in your resources. Don't put your trust in your ability. Don't put your trust in creatures. Put your trust in the creator. Don't put your trust in creatures, but to put your trust in the creator. While the creator is there, there is no need to put our trust in creatures. Put your trust in him because he's the Alpha and Omega. Put your trust in him because he's the beginning and the end. Put your trust in him because he's the head of all things. Noni atie nyinete en sare ho efa honkoto na body epia so abra wo body nyankopon na kasate ho na wo de honkoto na body so fa honto na so na wose won na de honto onyo nyankopon so no wonom te sa Zion people e him etim hota na sadie e me portra Jerusalem ho shia no sadie urate nyankopon en so twa ne man ho shia no. And our God has been proven trustworthy from ages to ages. He has been our God. And he's the same yesterday, today, and forever. And forever, oh God, the world is settled in heaven. This is the forever God. He's from the beginning to the end. He never changes. He's the Alpha and the Omega. Put all your trust in God Almighty, and he will never fail you. Psalm 22, verse number 4. Our fathers trusted in you. They trusted, and you delivered them. They cried to you, and were delivered. They trusted in you and were not ashamed. Hallelujah. So this is the word of God, and we believe that we shall never be ashamed, for they that trust in God shall never be ashamed. God bless you for listening to this awesome message of God, and I believe that your life will never be the same again. I'm A.D. Francis, Pastor Ajimedia Francis, the missionary. God bless you for your time, for the living word of God, and I'm believing God to bless you after listening to this word of God, for we are serving a God who will never fail. You are blessed. And you are highly favored in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Continue to listen to this channel, and there are more motivation messages for you, and there are more word of God for you, and your life will never be the same again. For we serve a God who never fail. Hallelujah. So we will trust in the greater rather than to trust in creatures. God is the beginning and the end, and the Alpha and the Omega. God bless you for your time, for his word. You are blessed. Amen. Thank you.